بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح للأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فعليه أفضل الصلاة وتم التسليم على آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين اللهم اجعلنا منهم ومن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر آمين يا رب العالمين وأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وقد أمرنا بالحق وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bearing witness that none has the right to be worshipped or unconditionally obeyed except for him and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger we ask Allah to send his peace and blessings upon him the prophets and messengers that came before him his family and companions that served alongside him and those that follow in his blessed path until the day of judgment and we ask Allah to make us amongst them Allahumma ameen Dear brothers and sisters, in today's khutbah, I want to address actually something that personally gave me some pause. And that is that sometimes we take for granted when Allah responds to us with how He is going to reward us, what exactly that means. Now, if I was to tell you an ayah or a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where the reward of such an act is غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ Everything that you have done before is forgiven. It is understood what that means. If I was to tell you that whoever sends salam on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ Allah and His angels send their prayers upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا Where Allah commands you, O you who believe, send your prayers upon him and send your salam to him. If I was to tell you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam responds with salam, as we know from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what that precisely means, that every single time you send salah and salam upon him sallallahu alaihi wasallam, an angel informs him and he responds to you by name. It is very clear, it is very explicit. If I was to tell you, as we get into the last 10 nights of Ramadan, when we remind ourselves of a dua that should be made throughout the year, Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. Oh Allah, you are the one who forgives, who pardons. You love to pardon, so pardon me, forgive me. It's very clear what that means. But if I was to ask you, what does it mean when Allah sends salah upon you? What does that even mean? Would anyone be able to answer except with something that is abstract or ambiguous? Because it just sounds so different. How does Allah send salah upon me? In fact, how does Allah send salah upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What does it mean to say Allah sends salah? Sends his prayers upon someone. And that's what I want to stick with for today's khutbah, inshaAllah ta'ala, so that the next time you hear the reward of Allah sending salah upon you, you know exactly what that means and how to connect it, and inshaAllah ta'ala, long for it and aspire towards it. Now, why now? Because last week we spoke about Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. The beautiful words, to Allah we belong and to Allah we return. The reward of which is أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ That verily those people who say, to Allah we belong and to Allah we return, as soon as a tragedy strikes them, upon them is the prayer of their Lord, And it should not be lost upon us the way that Allah has personalized this, as this is a form of tashrif. This is a form of making the recipient of this reward more noble, of honoring that person, that upon them is the prayer of their Lord and His mercy. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ And they are the ones who are rightly guided. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, since we've been in his seerah, it's only befitting that we mention his tafsir or his explanation of this verse. When he would read this verse radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he would say, نِعْمَ الْعَدْلَانِ وَنِعْمَةِ الْعِلَاوَةِ That how blessed is the compensation for the first two, and how blessed is the prize, the extra form of elevation that comes at the end of this verse. He says, as for al-adlan, the two forms of compensation that Allah mentions here for a person that says, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. He said, then it is as-salah wal-rahmah. Allah's prayer upon the person and Allah's mercy upon the person. He says, as for al-ilawa, he said, but the gold here, the prize, the extra form of elevation, he says, that is al-hidayah, that is the guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises. Why? Because if Allah guides you, then that means Allah will enter you into paradise. Right? So in many places in the Qur'an, where Allah mentions, inna hadaynahu sabil, we have guided them to the two paths. As Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma will mention, that means the path of guidance and the destination of guidance, which is paradise. It carries a double meaning when Allah speaks about guidance as a form of reward, it carries a double meaning. That you are blessed to have guidance in this life because you live a life of meaning and purpose. And the greater blessing is that the destination of guidance is paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the inhabitants of Jannat al-Firdaus. Allahumma ameen. Now, in this specific context, salah means something very specific, and that is al-maghfirah. That is His forgiveness. And we actually take this from a hadith where the Prophet ﷺ was receiving the sadaqah, receiving the charity of various people. And Abdullah ibn Abi Awfa, radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he says that when people would come to the Prophet ﷺ, he would say to them as they brought their sadaqah to him, he would say, Allahumma salli alayk. How amazing would it be to hear that from the Prophet ﷺ? The Prophet ﷺ would say, may Allah send salah upon you. That was the way that he would receive people when they would bring their sadaqah to him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We can't hear him say it to us, but that is a reward as well, that Allah sends His salah upon us. And the Prophet ﷺ said, sallaytu alayhi ashra, that I send salah upon that person as well. So here, Abdullah ibn Abi Awfa, he says that when my father came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I remember him saying, Allahumma salli ala Ali Abi Awfa. Oh Allah, send your prayers upon the family of Abi Awfa. And so the particular meaning here is forgiveness. The forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, when we recite in the end of the night, the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, wa'afu anna waghfir lana warhamna. Wa'afu anna waghfir lana warhamna. Okay? If you think about it, the order of it is actually what? Rahma is mercy. Forgiveness is that everything in as a result of Allah casting His mercy upon you. Forgiveness means that the sins no longer exist. Al-afu is that you are fully pardoned, that you now enjoy the reward post-forgiveness. So there is a degree here between forgiveness and mercy. And so here in this verse, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةً that verily Allah gives you His forgiveness and His mercy is the response to إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ Now that's the specific meaning in this verse. However, when it comes to as-salah in general, when Allah sends salah upon you, it carries multiple meanings that also encapsulate this. One of the things that we learn is that as we send salah on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah prays upon us, the angels pray upon us, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prays upon us. So we already established what that means for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As for the angels, Allah azza wa jalla says, "Takadu as-samawati yatafattarna min fawqihim wal malaikatu yusabbihuna bihamdi rabbihim wa yastaghfiruna liman fil ard, ala inna Allaha huwal ghafurur rahim." That the heavens almost creak above them and the angels exalt Allah with praise, and they ask forgiveness for those on earth. And of course, Allah says that the angels, what did they do as they roam around the throne of God? يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Subhanallah. What an amazing creation. They roam around the throne of God seeking forgiveness for those who believe. They're saying, Allahumma ighfir lahum, Allahumma ighfir lahum, Allahumma ighfir lahum. Oh Allah, forgive that person. Oh Allah, forgive that person. Oh Allah, forgive that person. And so the salah of the angels is specifically one of forgiveness, one of the angels seeking forgiveness for us. So that's understood. But when it comes to Allah, Allah praying upon you is unlike any other creation praying upon you, sending salah upon you. It's completely different because ultimately, when the Prophet ﷺ prays, who does he pray to? Allah. When the angels seek forgiveness, who are they seeking forgiveness from? Allah. They're seeking forgiveness for us from Allah, but they're praying to Allah. But when the Prophet, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself has this attribute of salah, there's something very special about that. And it actually combines all of the meanings in the most beautiful of ways. Number one, how amazing is it to have Allah even mention your name to the inhabitants of the heavens? So the most general meaning of the salah of Allah upon his creation is al-dhikr wa-thana fil mala'il a'la, that Allah mentions you in the highest heavens. Your name in a conversation between Allah and Jibreel alayhi salam. How incredible is that? Allah telling Jibreel alayhi salam, by the way, I want you to know, Jibreel, I love that person. Inni uhibbu fulan. I just want you to know I love that person. How much do you want to be the name that Allah is mentioning to Jibreel alayhi salam? And then Jibreel is shouting out to all of the angels in the heavens, Inna Allaha yuhibbu fulan. Allah loves this person. Just the thought of it, right? The thought that my name is being mentioned up there. You know, people want to see their names on plaques. People want to see their names engraved in certain places. To have your name being mentioned by Allah to Jibreel alayhi salam, and then Jibreel alayhi salam mentioning it to Mikael and Israfil and all of the angels and all of the prophets, because the inhabitants of the heavens includes all of those who have ascended thus far. Isa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, they're all hearing your name being praised through the heavens. How amazing is that, right? And Ubay ibn Ka'ab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the famous incident where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Ubay radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah has commanded me to recite Surah Al-Bayyinah to you. And Ubay started to cry and he said, Ya Rasulullah, Sammani? You mean Allah said Ubay? Did Allah just tell you recite to the next person that walks in? Did Allah tell you recite to one of your companions? Or did Allah say, Iqra ala Ubay? Read to Ubay, because Allah mentioning my name is special. He mentioned me? Yes, he mentioned you. And Ubay radiallahu ta'ala anhu was as if he forgot everything. So that's the special thing, right? Allah mentioning you in a praiseworthy way amongst the inhabitants of the heavens. Now let's connect it all together, inshaAllah ta'ala, as we go into the last or the first 10 days of the Hijjah, and the prize of the first 10 days of the Hijjah being Arafah. The greatest way that Allah can mention you in the presence of the inhabitants of the heavens is in the capacity of forgiveness. When Allah announces to the heavens, I have forgiven this person. There is nothing greater than that. Because, you know, if Allah praises you, it could be that the praise is limited to a praiseworthy deed that you did, right? It's beautiful. But there's still something limited about it in terms of what it covers. But when Allah announces to the heavens that He has forgiven you, that means that you are forgiven. And Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala explains, there is nothing after that. Like when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah looked at the veterans of Badr, and Allah says, it may be that I have forgiven them for everything that they've done before and everything after. That when Allah announces your amnesty, your forgiveness to the heavens, that's it. And if you think about the Day of Judgment, what is the moment that you long for? You know, there's the moment of meeting Allah and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala putting you at ease. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst them. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to us, as some of those secret sins that we struggled with, we didn't boast about, we weren't proud of them, but we struggled and we were trying, but ultimately we fell short, and Allah puts a hijab, a veil between you and everyone else, and says, come here, come close, and starts to mention some of those sins to you. And then Allah says, I want you to know that I concealed them for you in the dunya, and I'm forgiving you for them now. They're done, don't worry about them. No one's ever gonna hear about these sins, nor will you be confronted with them. Amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding you of your good deeds on the day of judgment. Can you imagine Allah telling you about your good deeds on the day of judgment? That's amazing, that's very comforting, that's very beautiful. A najwa, the secret conversation between you and Allah. That's what Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhumah mentioned, when as everyone is standing there and they're being called from the creation to stand in front of Allah, and you're speaking to Allah to the exclusion of everyone else. That's special, it's beautiful. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you your book in your right hand, that's the real celebration, right? Because that means I made it. That means I'm not going to be held accountable for my sins at this point. That's when the person takes the book and goes around running to everyone and saying, "Ha umuqra'u kitabiya," everyone go ahead and read my book. Here's my book of good deeds. Here's my prayer. Here's my charity. Here's that time that I showed honesty and it was not returned. Here's that time I showed ihsan to Allah's creation. Here's that time that I did this secret good deed and this secret good deed. Here it is. Oh, here it is, everyone. You're celebrating at that point. That's the moment of celebration, because up until that point, I don't know. There's still an anxiety of sorts, but that is the point where you celebrate. Now, as we get into Arafah, what does the salah of Allah mean upon you? Read this hadith differently now. When Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that on the day of Arafah, إِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ عَرَفَةَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَنزِلُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا فَيُبَاهِي بِهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. On the day of Arafah, Allah descends to the lowest heaven in a way that befits Him. And Allah boasts to the angels about His creation. Look at these people. Look at these people. Look at them making dua. Look at their struggles. انظروا إلى عبادي. SubhanAllah, like Allah is attributing the servants to Himself, which is again the greatest form of tashrif, the greatest form of honoring them. Look at them. Are not the angels the ibad of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Of course they are, but look at these ibad. Dusty, disheveled, tired, exhausted, but they are making dua consistently. And what is the ultimate prize? Ya malaika, O my angels, أُشْهِدُكُمْ أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. I want you all to bear witness that I've forgiven them. That's Allah's salah upon you. I want all of you angels to bear witness that these people, they're forgiven. I've given them amnesty. Now what do the angels do in general? يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, right? They seek forgiveness for those who believe. But even then, the angels say, يَا رَبْ, but يَا اللَّهُ, فُلَان كَانَ يُرَحَقْ, وَفُلَان وَفُلَانَ, but this person did this and this person did that. Just like when you come to the majalis of dhikr, the places of remembrance, but yeah, oh Allah, that person was insincere. They just came because their friend was coming to the halaqah. They just did this and you're going to forgive them? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. Case closed, I forgave them. Because they're in a righteous gathering. There's something about them that's enough for me to forgive them. And so the next time you hear, أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة. The next time you say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you imagine the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returning salam to you, and you imagine the angels seeking forgiveness for you as a result of that, the great prize is when Allah mentions your name to the angels in the highest heavens, and particularly mentions your name in the capacity of forgiveness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for all of our sins, those which we have done in the past and those in the present and those which we will undoubtedly commit in the future. May Allah forgive us for what we conceal and what we make public. May Allah forgive us for that which is minor and that which is major. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not allow us to stain ourselves with insistence upon that which is displeasing to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove all of that which makes us not praiseworthy in His sight and elevate us. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha. Wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'iril muslimin. Fastaghfiruhu innahu al-ghafur rahim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واعف عنا ولا تعذبنا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكوننا من الخاسرين اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم اغفر لوالدينا رب ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها اللهم أهلك الظالمين بالظالمين وأخرجنا وإخواننا من بينهم سالمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمائه يزد لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة